Oh, so it's time to do May's mission inspiration. I'm just going to start with gluing down some bits and bobs. Just wipe this out of the way so my book lies down. Okay, so I've taped down the middle, and I think I'm going to work on the double page this time. So I'm going to grab a spreader, and I've got my gel medium. And I've got these, I'm going to use as my labels. I don't really know what they're from, but they're from some form of packaging. Someone collected them for me. Put one down here. Clothing, some shoes, something like that, I don't know. But yeah. Pop these down there. And then I have these, I brought these from Marta, I do believe. They're very thick, so I'm hoping that they stick. So I'm going to pop this one here. Not really planned this, I'm just going for it. Let's have this one here. Very, very thick, sort of, it's like parchment paper sort of thing. And then this one right in the middle, I think. Well, near the middle. Let's get rid of that lumpy bit there. No idea where I'm going with this page, as always. Okay. it's all bubbling. Okay. See how it dries, I may end up pulling that off. Okay, so I'll be back once this is all dry. I'm going to let it dry naturally because I don't think that heating it would help. I think that'll just make it bubble even more. So we'll see what it looks like. Still got no idea what we're doing with this page. But let's get some colour, shall we? So I'm going to use my purple, it's just a Royal Langnickel purple. And pop that down here. Not too much. And I'm just going to use my card as a scraper. That's probably too much. Here we go. And I'm going to work from the middle out. I have gessoed this page with clear gesso. Just to give us a good surface. And then we're going to do the same the other way. More paint on the side. Make sure that everything's connected. Perhaps cover up that little planet there so it's not quite so obvious. That's the purple. Not really sure what to do with the teal. Okay, so that is purple and paint. We've still got markers to use, haven't we? And found objects. And I've got an idea for the grey. So, I need to find a focal image, some words. Still a lot to do. So, I'll be back once this is dry and I've thought of what I need to do next. Skip the P. paint a bit of a shake a shake. My Vallejo teal. Oh, let me just pause the video. I forgot. I was watching Honey. Right. Let's have a little dash of that. This is a Mike Deacon stencil. And I'm going to pop it right in the middle. And as I said, I'm going to work from the middle out. Oh, I love it. I love it. I'm not really sure why I've struggled so much with this. Because purple and teal are my favourite colours, so you would have thought I'd just gone, oh yeah, you know, just gone with it, but I don't know. Just don't know how to combine all the elements and make it look good, I suppose. Lovely. And then let's just have a hint of it coming out this way. So I'm going to put a very small amount on the sponge. Lovely. And maybe a bit down here. So I want a little bit more. No, I like that. Okay. And now what, ladies and gents? I have no idea. That's it. So I still need a found object. And I still need markers. So yet again, I'm going to have to go away. Have a look for something. Maybe have a little look in my bits and bobs. I'll be back. Okay, so for found objects, I'm just going to use this. Made up a nice grey. Just white and black, obviously. Just break up some of that purple. Okay. Now, just need to dry that off, and I think I knew what I want my focal point to be, I think. Give me a minute. I think I want this to be my focal point, and it's just deciding where to put it now. Maybe there. Yep. So what I'm gonna do is, it's one of those transfers with water. So I'm going to wet the page a little bit. Oop, drop the butterfly. It's probably a bit too wet. That's fine. And now I have to try and peel. Peel, peel, peel. Come on. Yes. Now. And then we pop it face down. Where we want it to go, about there-ish. And then I want some more water on the back. And let's see. What we've got. Let me grab a sponge of some sort and just dab and a push. Get it nice and evenly wet. Let me just see if that is. Wet enough? Do you think it should? Slide. Whoop. Pressure, gently push, okay. Well, it's on there. It's very shiny, isn't it? I give it a bit of a dry. I might clear gesso over it just to help it stay and not be so shiny if it dries shiny. I'll be back in a sec. Yeah, so it's dry. And it's very shiny still, so let's grab a little brush and just very, very gently over with this gesso. Just don't want to tear it where there's bubbles, although I think most of those bubbles are this underneath where it's stuck to that, so should be okay. But let's get some gesso on there. See how that dries, and now I have a quote, and I'm not sure if I want to just write it on with marker. Let me think. Black. think we may have to go with black. So, I'm not going to do anything too fancy. Edge there. There we go. Now then, what did we do? Okay, no. There it is. Date stamp. Okay, so today is the 9th. June 2021. Gray. I have seen this month's prompts, so I've only just finished May's, and now I need to do June's. But there we go. Right, so I just want a pen just to write in the corner. M.I. May. Okay. So. I'll dry this off and then we'll go back just to have a quick look. See if this is going to work today. Yes. So I'm just going to go around this butterfly. To lift it off the page. Still quite shiny. so I can do this. Over the antenna. There we go. I think that's going to be everything for that page. I hope you enjoyed watching that. Please remember to go over to the Mission Inspiration Facebook page to join the fun. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Bye bye.